Business Studies with Smartere. This is a channel that allows you to learn on different business tips, and if you're a business student out there, this is a channel that will give you an opportunity to learn on different business principles and concepts, and basically all the information that you need for you to get that distinction, that exam. And it's simple. All you need to do is subscribe, watch, and learn. Okay, now today we are going to be looking at yet another interesting topic, but still under business, and our topic of discussion today is our business transactions. Okay, now without wasting much time, let's dive into it. Okay, now what is a business transaction? Now, business transactions can be defined differently by different people out there, and today we'll be looking at the different definitions for business transactions, and then we'll also look at the different types of business transactions that are there, and then we'll get to understand them as we go on like that. Okay, so what is a business transaction? Now, a business transaction is simply the exchange of money for something which has value. Okay, so a business transaction can also be defined as the exchange of something for another item which also has monetary value attached to it. Okay, so a business transaction can also be defined as the exchange of something for something. Okay, and now when we are talking about business transactions being the exchange of things for other things which have monetary value, what we are simply saying here is that you can exchange goods for other goods, or services for other services, or vice versa. Okay, so there you have it. A business transaction is simply the exchange of money for something which has value, or simply the exchange of goods for other goods, or you can actually define a business transaction as the act of buying and selling. Okay, so the act of buying and selling can also qualify to be the definition for business transactions. Okay, so there you have it, three definitions for business transactions. We are saying a business transaction is simply the exchange of money for something which has value, or the exchange of goods for other goods, or services for other services, or simply the act of buying and selling. Okay, now with that being said, we move on to another item, but to under business transactions. Now, we have different types of business transactions, and basically we have three main types of business transactions, namely cash transactions, credit transactions, and we also have what is known as barter transactions. Okay, now, we are going to look at each one of these individually, and then we get to understand everything involved in these types of business transactions that we have just mentioned. Now, the first type of business transaction that we're going to look at is what is known as the cash transaction. Okay, now, cash transactions are simply business transactions where payment for goods or services is made or done immediately at the point of sale. Okay, so the other thing that you need to know when you're talking about cash transactions is that in a cash transaction, change of ownership for goods or services is also transferred immediately when payment is made. Okay, so the moment you make that payment at the point of sale, even the ownership of the goods or the services will also change. Okay, so that is another thing that you need to know when you're talking about cash transactions. Okay, and then also the other thing that is of great importance to note when you're talking about cash transactions is that whenever a cash transaction has taken place, a source document known as a receipt is always issued to the customer. Okay, so the customer will always go with the original receipt, while the seller will remain with the duplicate receipt. Okay, now still under cash transactions, the other thing that you need to know is that cash transactions are classified into two categories. Okay, and the first category is what is known as the cash receipt transaction. Okay, and then we also have what is known as the cash payment transaction. Okay, so those are the two categories which will fall under cash transactions. Okay, and when we're talking about the cash receipt transaction, we are simply talking about transactions that will increase the balance in a current account of a particular person or business. Okay, and then the cash payment transactions are those transactions that will reduce the current balance in one's account. Okay, so we move on to the next type of business transaction, and the next business transaction that we're going to be looking at is what is known as a credit transaction. Okay, Now, a credit transaction is simply a transaction where payment for goods or services is not made immediately at the point of sale, but at a later date or time in future, okay? So any type of transaction where you don't pay for the goods or services immediately at the point of sale is referred to as a credit transaction, okay? Now, with a credit transaction, we are simply saying that a payment for goods will be made at a later date, or payment for services will be made at a later date, and therefore the transfer of ownership will also not take place at the point of sale, but only when the full payment for that particular good or service is made. That's when the ownership will be transferred to the other party. Okay, so we are saying credit transactions are simply transactions where payment for goods and services is not made immediately at the point of sale, but at a later time or date in future, okay? And that the transfer of ownership will also take place only when full payment is made. When a credit transaction has taken place, again, there's a need for documentation to show that actually a transaction took place, okay? And now, whenever somebody buys something on credit, the seller will always issue out a source document referred to as an invoice, and the buyer will go out with the original invoice, while the seller will always remain with the duplicate invoice. Okay, so those are some of the things that you need to know when we talk about credit transactions. So in summary, what we are simply saying is that a credit transaction is where payment is not made immediately at the point of sale, but at a later date or time in future. And whenever a credit transaction has taken place, the seller will issue out an invoice to the customer, and the customer will go with the original invoice, while the seller will remain with the immediate invoice, which the seller will later on use to enter those details in the tables. Okay, now, we move on to another type of business transaction, and the next type of business transaction that we're going to look at is what is known as a barter transaction, okay? Now, when we are talking about barter transactions, these are simply transactions where people exchange goods for other goods, or services for other services, or even vice versa, goods for services or services for goods, okay? Now, this type of transaction is sometimes referred to as one-on-one trading system, okay, because it involves two parties involved in the transaction to actually meet and negotiate on the transaction or the exchange process, okay. Now, this is where, for example, you have a bag of rice, and then another one has a bag of wheat, okay, or flour, and then you decide to exchange, okay. So you actually negotiate the value of the good that you have, or the item that you have, with that which the other one will have, okay. So you come together and actually negotiate on how much each one will cost, and then if there's need for any top-ups to be made, you do it like that from there. Okay, so we are simply saying barter transactions will not involve any form of cash in the transaction, but instead it will only involve the exchange of goods for other goods, or services for other services, or even vice versa, okay? No solid cash is going to be involved when you are dealing with barter transactions, okay? So there you have it. Barter transaction is simply the exchange of goods for other goods, or services for other services, or vice versa, okay? Without the involvement of any cash in the transaction. But of course, again, even when we are saying it will only involve the exchange of goods and services, it doesn't mean that the goods or services in question will not have any money that you have attached to them, okay? So all the goods and all the services that you exchange in a barter transaction should have what is known as monetary value attached to them, okay? So there you have it, and again, if you're finding this information to be very helpful, please don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, then please leave comments so that I get to know what you people think about my videos. If you like them, please leave the information down there, and also tell me the next topic that you want us to discuss on, and I'll definitely do that for you. Okay, now before we come to the end of our video for today, there's another thing that I thought I should share with you, and this is on what is referred to as a commercial transaction. Okay, now what is a commercial transaction? Okay, remember we said we have three main types of transactions, okay, but now I'm bringing something new, and this is our commercial transactions. Now, what is a commercial transaction? Now, a commercial transaction is simply a transaction which is conducted between two businesses, okay? Where a trader who go and buy goods or services from another trader, or a trader selling goods or services to another trader, okay? A good example that I can give you on commercial transactions is where a retailer will go to the wholesaler to buy goods, or where a wholesaler will go to the manufacturer or producer to buy goods, okay? Or actually vice versa, the producer selling to the wholesaler, or the wholesaler selling to the retailer. Those are traders are selling to one another like that, okay? So that qualifies to be a commercial transaction, because remember, the word commercial is something that people will use to refer to business, okay? And now when we're talking about commercial transactions, there's one thing that you need to understand here, okay? A commercial transaction can either be a credit transaction or a cash transaction, okay? Depending on the method of payment which is going to be used there, okay? It can be a credit transaction if one trader goes to another trader to buy goods on credit, okay? That will qualify it to be a credit transaction, but it is still a commercial transaction, because those are traders involved in that business activity there, okay? Now, it can also qualify to be a cash transaction if one trader goes to another trader to buy goods on cash. They pay cash immediately at the point of sale, okay? Then that is a commercial transaction under a cash transaction, because payment has been made immediately at the point of sale, okay? So there you have it. A commercial transaction can either be a credit transaction or a cash transaction, depending on the method of payment that is going. And of course, it can also maybe qualify to be a barter transaction if they are exchanging goods for other services or goods for other goods, okay? And they are both traders there. So commercial transactions will involve two traders or more traders coming together to do business like that, okay? And on that note, we come to the end of our video for today. Please remember to stay safe out there, because you are the people that support me by watching these videos, and I need you people safe out there, because without you people, my videos will have no one to watch, okay? So I'll see you in my next video, and I love you. Bye-bye.